everyone, my name's Erika and I am this year's Middlesex County 4-H intern. Today I'm going to be teaching you guys how to make a floral arrangement out of the plants inside or outside your home. But before we get started, there's a couple of safety tips I want to give you. The first one is if you're going out in the woods or anywhere around your house, you might want to put on some long pants to avoid things like ticks and other bugs. You also might want to put on long sleeves and gloves because you don't want to get any poison ivy. There's going to be a document listed that shows what poison ivy, poison sumac, and poison oak all look like. So, before we get started, we're also going to want to cut everything. So you want to cut like all your flowers, you want to cut all your greens or whatever foliage you're going to use, and you're also going to want to grab a vase to put everything in, filled with water, and then an actual vase to go inside your home. You'll also need scissors for your smaller stems and pruners for your more wooden stems. So I started off by using this Rose of Sharon. It's pretty woody, has a really thick stem, so if I was to use scissors, it would be really difficult. I could hurt myself or I could really mess up these scissors. So I'm going to use my pruners. When you're going to actually make the bouquet, you're going to want to cut off a little bit of the ends just because you're going to want the stems to be able to take up more water. So I'm going to just start putting these guys in there. Take out whatever leaves you have that might touch the water, because the leaves in the water will cause bacteria to grow and your plants to die more quickly. You're also going to want to pick a direction for your bouquet to be facing. So I'm going to want it front facing, but I'm going to make it face you guys, so it might look a little funny. So I'm going to take my zinnia. It is an annual, which means it comes back once a year. Another one. I'm going to cut it. I'm going to place it in the front. I also have some dahlias, which are another annual. I'm going to want this guy to be more towards the back. Grass that I have in my yard is just going to be a nice focal point, a nice really tall aspect to your bouquet. Give a little bit of texture, a little bit more color, that kind of thing. You could also take this and you can wrap it around your vase. You could do whatever. Just be creative, have fun, do whatever you want. It's also helpful if you make X's throughout the base with your stems, because then it will give you more of a sturdy base to put things in, and rather than continuing to put more and more things in, you could actually just, instead of more arranging, instead of a ton of arranging, you can just put in more stems and then they'll be more secure and just be stable. Also, if we're going to do this in the house, definitely get a trash can around, because I have a ton of leaves and stems that you're going to want to put in the trash and not leave out for your parents or guardian to clean up, because they will be upset with you. Also, if you have pets in the house, you don't want them to eat this stuff, just because you don't know how that will react with their digestive system. Side of my house. This is a nice potted plant that I got, and I'm just gonna use that because it's nice, it's fresh, it'll last a while because I'm just cutting it now instead of waiting throughout the day to cut it. intern, you're gonna wanna just grab a couple inches up and then just pull off all the leaves. So like I said, it doesn't go in the water. And just put it in there to add a little bit more color, a little bit more texture. If you live in an area where you don't have access to a lot of plants outside, or you live in a condo or an apartment, but you have an aunt or an uncle or a grandma or a friend down the road, maybe ask them if you can go into their yard and pick some plants and some flowers. But make sure you ask them, and make sure you tell your parent or guardian where you're going before you leave the house. Okay. I have one dahlia left, but I don't know if I'm going to use it. Cut these grasses a little bit too long, so I'm going to chop them up a little more. Stick them back in here. You can also shift them around once they're underwater and give that a little bit more of a... Like I said, it'll be a little bit more stable now that you have a bunch of plants already in here, so it'll be a lot easier for you to move and manipulate things. Maybe not. Keep adding on for as long as you want. Just make sure you don't overfill the vase. It's also helpful to have a clear vase because then you can see exactly where all your roots are. Alright. And I have one dahlia left. Bye guys!